Happy to see all of you at our first webinar in Fieldbee. We have a few rules. Just please mute your microphone and your camera in order not to interrupt other people. Actually, camera you can leave. It's nice to see real people. Just maybe mute your microphone. That would be good. And my name is Natalie. I'm a marketing and sales manager in Fieldbee. And today I will start this webinar, and then I will give word to Alexey and to Taras, our technical team. And to start, I would like to share with you a few slides. So I know that here, according to the questions and also people who replied to us, we have people who are already our customers, like highly even for a long time. And also we have new people who don't have our product. So that's why also I would like to give a small introduction about our company. And then we can go to discuss your questions as was promised. So Fieldbee company and Fieldbee products, they were created by Alexey actually 10 years ago. He created application, e-farmer app for farmers. And since then, we started this company. And we created first tractor navigation application for smartphones. It was renamed to Fieldbee last year, and then also we launched RTK receiver for farmers, and it was done during crowdfunding campaign with farmers from 30 countries, and so a lot of farmers gave us their feedback and ideas how the products should work. So that's how we actually develop our products, because e-farmer is IT company. We are based in Ukraine and Netherlands, and we are IT guys. And the project started because we really like farmers and we appreciate the work that you do. And as technical guys, we see that you could use some technologies in your work to make this work easier for you and more efficient. And the time that we have now, it has a lot of challenges for farmers. You know, the population is growing, people continue to eat and eat more, and then all this climate change, etc., etc. So many issues, and that's why we see technologies should be there for you. And here, that's where we see our mission to make them available for everyone. Because when we started 6 years ago, we the products like tractor navigation, they were already on the market, but they were so expensive that farmers could not use them. That's why we want to make products that are more affordable and more available for farmers. For now, e-farmer and Fieldbee products, like our application is downloaded by now, actually, by more than 170,000 people worldwide, and we have more than 2,000 customers, and we have customers, farmers who use Fieldbee equipment in more than 50 countries. So we're a really international company, and we feel this, that farmers everywhere, they're the same, you know. That is really amazing. One more time, just big thank you for all your hard work that you are doing. Because we visited many farmers, many customers, and we just know how difficult it is. So our thank you to you. For this webinar particularly, we collected a lot of questions from you. Actually, we got questions from 38 countries. And if you see on your screens, there is a comment, chat possibility. So maybe you can write us in chat from which country are you. It would be very interesting to see. And so we saw that we have very different questions and a lot of questions, which is great. And that we need more time to discover all of them. That's why this meeting, we set it up as overview. So we will cover questions about tractor auto-steer, questions about RTK system and receivers, questions about functionality, and also we will at the end define some time for questions, live questions from you who are on this event. So that will be the outline of our meeting, and we promise that we will go deeper, because we see that we will not be able to cover everything. So that's why we decided to you will receive this invitation to join our FieldView Ninja Club, and there we will continue our webinars with deeply learning functionality and possibilities of FieldView. And also we will ask maybe our users, pro users, to share their experience. So it's kind of like real farmer experience for you. And also, please, questions that you submitted to us, we will try to cover some them, but some of them maybe not will be answered, and we promise to answer them personally and also in next webinars. There are some rules. Yes, I already mentioned it, that please mute your microphone in order not to interrupt Alexey. And I think for now, that's it, what I wanted to tell. And now I would like to invite Alexey, our technical guru. And please, Alexey, share your answers to questions.
Okay. Yes, thank you Natalia for introduction, and let's continue. Just 1 second, I'll share that it's my presentation. Natalia is presenting. Yeah, can you see my screen? Yeah, everything okay?
Yeah.
Okay, let's continue. First of all, thank you for your time that you want to share it, your experience, your question with us. And for me, it's important. And I want to say that during preparation to this webinar, we receive a lot of questions from different countries, and currently it's international webinar. Just if you see some echo, please mute Iron. Please mute microphone. That's can we interrupt? We received some question. We have some product lines, and we have a different categories of this question. And that webinar is organized by according our product line, so according after steer system, FieldView, GNSS, RTK kits, navigation app. And also I want to tell about some question about the integration with third-party system, with third-party hardware. And also we discuss what we can do the next. And first of all, I want to say that our products based on feedbacks, and is necessary to receive some feedbacks from you, because currently you can impact on the next iteration improvement of products, and that's for that also many thanks for you. So just Natalie made a short introduction. Yeah, I have about that 10 years experience in ECTech. I built the ERP system for farm management, and also have experience with integration with precision farming and all product designed with me and my team. So Natalie, yes, she's managed all question about marketing and sales. And Taras also today, for I think the most of all of our current customers now that Taras Clear also. So during this conversation webinar, we will speak all of us. and let's start. First of all, I want to start. It's about our whole product, the fully complete, that after steer system. And you know that basically we provide in Google Play, Philbee, tractor GPS navigation system, which allow to the navigation functionality and record keeping functionality. And our system allow to make upgradable model. So that means you can use that you can use our additional modules. RTK kits for improving accuracy because Android not allow to high precision positioning with internal GPS. Currently, some smartphones, some devices already equipped more precise GNSS receiver. Also, some GNSS receiver integrated in Android devices. Has a better accuracy, but during using inside in cabin, it compromised solution. So it can be applicable only for tracking and understanding what kind of field you have done or what kind of field you're going to do, just for understanding what's happening, just for tracking. For navigation, need to use external devices. And we see that a few years ago, thank you all farmers who support us, with L1 receiver, we build the first generation of receiver, which provided accuracy in centimeter accuracy in 10 kilometers range over internet and 2.5 kilometers over radio. And that means this kit can be connected to the Android device over Bluetooth for working with more precise accuracy with navigation, with light bar. And also this kit can be upgraded with automatic steering controller. So this automatic steering controller we choose from the best, one of the best of ECU of after guidance controllers, which made it by company No Variant, currently is Egg Junction. This controller on the market use other companies like Egg Leader and New Holland also use this controller for equipping tractor on production line. And also that this configuration of Android application, Android tablet, RTK kit and ECU controller currently also equipped on production line currently in Turkey, for example. So that's also for tractor manufacturers ready product. And this controller allow us to provide this upgradable option to work with hands-free. And this controller allow to use different configuration with connecting to your tractor, with integrating. So that's the first type of integration is mechanical driver unit. When you can upgrade, we have a manual step-by-step when even farmer with remote support, of course, help and assist to install this system, all kits on your tractor. Also, and mechanical driver unit allow to upgrade your system, yeah, with minimum impact on your tractor, and also. This configuration with mechanical driver unit, which install it on steering wheel, and can we equip it with switch kit? So that's allow to switch current installation on other tractor. So that's this whole product configuration. We also provide and try to keep that wireless connection, so the tablet is connected to ECU controller over Wi-Fi. Receiver via cable, but the minimum cables which need to connect it, and minimum time for switching kit from one tractor to the second tractor. So we are thinking all time about the upgrading option or switching option. Also, the the next configuration is hydraulic installation. So that's mean it's required more hydraulic skills, and sometimes it's also required service engineer. And if all our products currently supplying over internet. So we deliver and supporting remotely. In some country, for example, in Turkey, we can provide its installation service. But now we also in Europe organized its servicing servicing with installation hydraulic configuration. So that means additional valve which installed in your current hydraulic system with interface, electric interface, which connected to ECU controller. And with this configuration, you will have that possibility to drive with higher speed and more accurate positioning. And also some tractors already pre-equipped by tractor manufacturer company on production line, which call them automatic steering ready tractors. So this mean a hydraulic valve additional or electric steering already available over CAN bus or specific extended socket. So that's in this case you need just activate this functionality, connect this ECU controller to your tractor, unlock this precision navigation option, and you can start using the after guidance system with steering ready tractor. So that's about whole kit installation, and step by step you can upgrade from just navigation system with light bar to automatic steering system. And I want to say again about I like that edit mode all time adjustment. Yeah, I just also shared this presentation. It's much better. Yeah, with hydraulic automatic steering, we received some question from USA and Canada about regarding installation. Just a few comments about it. So it's required additional valve, and you, if you have hydraulic specialist or some your service manager for your tractor now has experience with installation a Glider system or Raven system, so they can we can study explain how it will be installed. We can instruct service manager for installing hydraulic system to your tractor. So for hydraulic installation, you need additional valve which connected parallel in your hydraulic system, and the angle sensor. So the angle sensor installed on front wheels, calibrate and made a response about the current angle of your front wheels. So this configuration possible, but it's required more skills with installation and supporting the hydraulic system. So that's some. Just let's continue. Taras, please comment few words about that question which we receive from customers, and I mute microphone. Just 1 second. I'm muting microphone. I need to switch here. Yeah.
Hello, everyone. It is nice to see you. We had a chance to communicate a lot with different of you about the different questions, and right now we have a chance to communicate personally. So we had a few requests about the John Deere tractors and possibility to install the auto steering system for this tractors. As Alexey mentioned in previous slide, there are options for steering main components. So some of tractors are already steer ready. Some of them can be upgraded with the hydraulic valve, and the benefit of using the mechanical driver unit that it can be installed to the old models of the vehicles. So for supporting and installing the system, it will be necessary for us to check which type of steering system can be installed, and are there any options for example, steer ready or hydraulic system. So it will be that you have your own vehicle and you know exactly the mark and model. You just send a request for our info@philb.com. And we will check which steering component will be the best for your truck. So for example, there was mentioned John Deere 6150 R series. So we have already checked and it is still ready and can be adjusted with the installing only the steer ready cable with the ECU. So no additional steer components, only the ECU controller and cable which will be connected to the kennel for your tractor. The next one, the questions from the Turkey, is it possible to have a system in Turkey? Yes, and we have a representative as a Turk tractor there, and there is a New Holland TD, a series with the model 110 that it is equipped with the ECU and Field B navigation system. As you can contact a Turk tractor and get information about the navigation system from the Field B. About the supporting US customers and communicating with the improvement and making wider, widespread in the navigation system by Field B. We are looking for the distributors in the US, and also it will be interesting for us to have such person if there are any contacts or you have contacts of the distributors. And also it is possible to be the ambassador of the Field B in the United States for a testing system, to work in the system with the system, sharing the photos, videos of the performance at the field. So we will have a base of the material which we can share, and neighbors or person from US also can be interested and know the contact of such person. So we are welcoming your contacts, sharing the photos, videos, and that's it. Yep.
Thank you, Taras. Let's continue. So that's we also receive the question about third-party controllers, after-steer controllers, I mean. And so we have experience when some controllers made it also by X junction. So this controller looks like ECU S1, this call, it's look like in this unit. And by a leader, for example, on track 3. So that's this controller can be connected to the Field B. So this Field B can provide the RTK position accuracy for this controller, and some customers use this this option with integration. What about that other case when you have a controller with simple steer? Need to check that if you have a Wi-Fi interface, you can activate this interface and try this system as is. So that's easy to test. You just download application. You have a trial period, so 10 days, or you can request extend trial period with us, and you can try to connect from Android navigation application to your automatic steering controller, which you have made it by X junction. So that's it's not required additional parameters and so on. Just activate Wi-Fi and try to connect to this. Simple steer can still use in parallel, so you can switch between simple steer and back to the QB navigation app. So just try it, communicate, get us feedback, and we will support with trying this option. Let's continue. And that's about automatic steering. That's we receive some additional question. If you have new question, you can write down in the chat, so you later back or we'll back on next meeting. Okay. Let's continue about FieldB RTK kit. So that's most of all if you know that's about the first generation of receiver. It's our first product. We made a lot of studies during this, made in this product a lot of field trials also with you. And during our investigation, we see that we can improve product in this year. And we made this second generation of this receiver, which work in double frequency, which based on double frequency RTK receiver. Which allow to get the first of all get RTK from end-trip network via virtual relation stations. So that's first generation can work only. I think some participants now that's about end-trip network, and the question that when we choose the nearest mount point, so that's this next generation of receiver can work with virtual relation station mount point. It's allowed to get RTK in region when it's not available. I think Walter maybe now. So I think some participant now about these cases. The next it's about the time for getting RTK. So that's first generation. During working close to the trees and go driving under trees, they have an RTK losing and making requisition time for of RTK was 3 minutes or more, sometimes different, and so it's really sensitive to weather and some environment around this using. And new generation use that double frequency two channels from the satellites, and that mean it's allow the more accurate positioning and faster RTK requisition time, also much faster. So that mean under trees you can lose RTK, but after go out from the trees, your RTK is back immediately, and we didn't catch that some jumps from float RTK to RTK. So that's important improvements with new generation. And I think it's necessary for, I'll tell maybe some question, yes. So that's just, I want to explain that's different between two generation. And new generation also has a serial port output with near interface which provide the positioning in 10 hertz, one speed baud rate. So that's it's necessary in current firmware. We support only one speed, but it's slow to connect most of all terminals. But I think some terminals has 38,000 baud rates. But currently you can use it for your other application for integrating to your system. So it's have to be equipped additional cables, custom cable, which allow it connect sprayers, controller terminals to FieldB. So that's important VRS and with base station. So is end-trip network not is not free in your country. Yet I think that this technology is coming, and you can use that base station, and new generation allow to transmit correction and RTK possible in 20 kilometers. And I know that some customer work pretty well is more distance than 10 kilometers, but foil to receiver RTK you can work stable, reliable, and fast faster, it's much faster performance of RTK. And also for manual guidance, now we have a hardware ready. Firmware is not, so we are working on it, that on functionality till compensation. So that means during upgrading only navigation app with L2 receiver without automatic steer, you'll get a till compensation and position will not shaken. So that's, we will compensate in range 15 degrees. And we will back this position to the right position. And one important thing that I missed during explanation about automatic steering, that tilt compensation integrated to automatic steering controller. So that means after upgrading to automatic steering controller, for example, with L1 receiver, so that tilt compensation will work also. But for L2 receiver, it's advantage if you will use that manual mode, driving mode with light bar. So that's also will compensate. I think in autumn we will release this functionality. And we are working also on CAN bus interface. So that's in the future when you will use that additional guidance system, maybe automatic system, so that all time we are thinking about the possibility to upgrade and using this other system. Maybe some customer use this entry for use with other application for surveying, for cadastral calculations, and other connect to the sprayer controller with own guidance system. So that's this product can be use it separately or together with whole system, and that is important. It's we also thinking about that this unit hardware idea for CAN bus integration, and also about the autonomous work. So that's also. When RTK is not achievable or base station is offline, you're far from your house and you cannot manage, for example, this case. Autonomous work also, it's about sub-meter accuracy and pass-to-pass accuracy 20-30 centimeters. So that's L2 receiver also will be applicable for some spraying operation, and so you can start. That's some characteristic is missing, but it's necessary. We are using this GPS multi-constellation in L2 receivers. So for L1 generation, we use only GPS plus GLONASS. Now we are using that GLONASS, Baidu, Galileo, and so it's allowed to get a stable, reliable RTK. So just keep in mind that in 20 kilometers you receive RTK. In 20 kilometers with various also possible, so that's mean in your country, in Belgium, FLEPAS, SAPAS in Germany, so that's this network can be used, and also other paid services can be also used by L2 receiver.
Alexey, I would like to add something about this, you told us that we have customers who has signal, RTK signal at 100 kilometers even.
Yeah, yes, that's case. It's I want to say that it's exception, but it's applicable for him that some region, so it's South Africa, yeah, that's it's float RTK, but it's centimeter accuracy. So that's our first generation is sensitive also for the region, some reflection impact on performance RTK, and so that's mean if you want to upgrade, you see that's not enough RTK L1 accuracy or performance, just look at a new generation. We provide that some offer for our current customers for upgrading. You just pay for the difference. So we made a special offer for our current customers for upgrading to new generation. So just you can ask and send your interest to Natalie, and we'll review that possibility to make a upgrade. So that's let's continue some question regarding L2 receiver. It's from which country we receive, from Italy, from United Kingdom, from Uzbekistan, Netherlands. So that's the question, typical question about the 10 kilometers. So that's when it's happened, if you lose RTK signal, you have to, in case you on the field, you don't have internet, good internet connection, you have to use the mobile base station configuration. So in this case, through the radio, a correction will be transmitted to your field. So that's mean need to use that for fields which far from you or with bad internet connection, you need a base station. Otherwise, you will work with low performance in autonomous work. Without base station, it will be 20-30 centimeters pass-to-pass accuracy. So that's relative accuracy will be good, but absolute accuracy is around 1 meter. So that's also question about it, about L2 receiver. Now we also choose that about that new technology and also affordable solution and valuable solution. And we choose that current RTK model. This model has 184 channels for receiving RTK signals from satellites, and it's double frequency receiver. That means this receiver don't require it EGNOS correction because it's already by autonomously provide submitter accuracy. So you just use L2 receiver for getting better accuracy in a region where is SBUS is not available. So it's applicable, for example, in Turkey or some other region. So doesn't important to use SBUS correction for L2 generation. Regarding L5, this technology is coming, and currently L5 is not available in current generation. I think it will be field B L5, because not all satellites using this technology, and maybe in few years we will provide this upgrade. Some question about the sharing location over Wi-Fi to third-party application. Yeah, we have white paper which explained how you can use some application in Android with mock location provider. You can share RTK positioning from field B to your application which you are using for cadastral, for surveying, and so on. So just you can request to the support about that how you can connect. We explained how you can do it. So this over additional application you can share this positioning from field B to other application. For example, to the Google Map, yeah, and navigate in a car with centimeter accuracy. So just by request. Some from Uzbekistan question about that electromagnetic fields and some sensitive for power lines. It depends on region, of course, and of fields. And if you have interference source, it can impact on performance. It can impact on performance, of course, even on your cell phone, on your radio, and so on. So that's why we provide that 30-day money back when you can test product on your field and your environment, and then decide is it applicable for you or not. So that's, of course, it's all can impact, but it's important that your field have to be under open sky, good visible horizon. So in this case you will have that good good ATK positioning, and that also about some cases. And yeah, we have a lot of cases when close to the power line there are no interference. So that's if noises not in a range 1.5 gigahertz, where is satellite is transmitting signal, you will work fine. So even you will not have some noises in your cell phone. So just test for and identify these sources. Let's continue. I like that FieldB next generation. I can tell more about FieldB L1. Some our great customer from Netherlands ask about it. Not all time of ATK. Yes, so that's if you have not a good performance of ATK, you can ask and look on new generation of FieldB. Just you can order it. We provide it special price. You will test it. If it's okay, you will upgrade to new generation. Just keep in mind this option. We are working improving all time, and you can also make upgrading with us. So it's about FieldB.
I just want to add something. I'm reading comments and you don't see them, so I also want to share that we have people from Paraguay, Jerry Duke, hi, and also from Pakistan, and many other countries, which is actually amazing. Thank you, everyone. Yeah, it's truly, truly amazing to see all of you. Somebody says that he just came from rice field and joined the webinar. Really cool. And please, guys, if you have questions on things that Alexey shared, something that you want to learn today, extra questions, please write them in the chat. We collect them, and at the end, we will give also 10 minutes to your questions. Okay, Alexey, thank you. Uh-huh. We can continue.
Yeah, just Taras said that Mais Biman, from South Africa, so this he has good position in this FieldB and huge range baseline. And thank you for feedbacks. For us it's important. Any feedbacks, and we are using it for improvement. Let's continue about Genesis receiver, and I want to note that today, before webinar, we received a lot of questions, and we made this webinar like overview. Then I add some additional notes about it, what we can do the next. About FieldB application, this application is designed for combining this navigation and record keeping, so that you can keep additional of your field activities in directly in application, and some customer using and like this functionality for preparation government report, and for example managing works where FieldB is not installed. For example, together with Fazer, work on some farmer work with FieldB navigation for plowing operation, and further on spraying operation on sprayer which equipped with Trimble, for example. And the young farmer, he make a record keeping activities about further activities, and then he's using reports from application for preparation government reports. So that's just notes. You can combine this information together in one app, and that's why we are using. Now we are also thinking about that simple using navigation without any record keeping. So that's if you have some ideas, do you need only calculator, for example, just navigation, or you need more options for record keeping, you can write down, send feedbacks, and just next slides we discuss it, and I explain that it's what is the opportunity we have together. So that's for navigation, that's Android application, and all time we're improving. You all time, you know, that's upgrading to better version, roll back again, and sometimes it's happened. We still working, and maybe someone know about the new functionality we added, AB manual patterns, which allow to put A and B button manually for AB straight. So that's easy because we receive a lot of feedbacks when AB lines lose it and, for example, forgot to put B button. So that's this functionality is available from version 6.4 from this month. Now it's beta stage, but you can try this functionality. We think this available functionality. Also, beginning of this year, we start working on headland several times pattern when you have to drive several times headland and then inside on the field, and notify that information about how far from the headland you implement. So that's now this functionality is still in development stage. Maybe in this year we finalize this functionality, but if it's necessary, headland pattern is several times for you, just write down about your ideas and your requirements for this, because your feedbacks allow us to make a prioritization on our roadmap, and so we can just we will concentrate on some most interesting for all world. Yes, so this functionality. Yes, it's about the latest news. So this about AB manual patterns and functionality which we are working on. It is still it's not available, but I think it will be available in this year. About the question, about questions about navigation. It's difficult to. So our goal with this application and with our old products, it's optimize mechanical optimized field work. So that's when we want to decrease amount of turns. That's our idea, and decrease time of field works. We received some question from Poland about that, how can be possible to proceed that field with difficult geometry, like with wedges, like triangle, some difficult, not applicable the normal pattern. And currently, just for example, that some our farmers use that turn land pattern for processing and working on a difficult configuration of fields. So that's Andrei, I don't know, he's joined it or to meeting from Poland. Oh. Andrei, no. Okay. But anyway, that's the idea is, of course, to apply that some normal optimal patterns, and sometimes you can use, for example, saved tracks pattern. So we have two types of patterns which call that recent patterns. So it's virtual lines which calculated for the line. You just can create a B line and use it for the next field works. It's virtual lines. Saved tracks, and that's mean, for example, this difficult pattern we not implemented in application. You can drive manually according this pattern, and then use the save tracks for the next field works, for the next time, make navigation according this previous line. So that's sometimes you can use this trick and use this save track patterns for covering some difficult fields. And about navigation, it's really open question for discussion. So it's open discussion. I think that today we made an overview this question. We just present this question from different region, and then we made a specific additional webinar specifically by some topics which is necessary for you. And now you see that overview of question. You can see that a lot of question. And just I'm waiting that additional question for the next webinars. Yeah, and some question about the layers, obstacles from Ireland and from United Kingdom about surveying operation. Yeah, so we have a record keeping and need to improve this functionality, and some customers using this functionality. Yeah, that now we are collecting some feedbacks how we can optimize keep record keeping, and maybe with RTK application with high positioning. And let me explain that's how it's possible, and some requests from Belgium about implement of sets in glossary for keeping parameters for the implement, and using this implement of set parameters for the new operations. And so let's see if we start from this question with implement from parameters from version 6.4 in glossary. When you enter information about the implement, where you put information about year, implement width. Now you can define that offset parameters of implement relative to GPS position. So in this case, if you fill this parameter for your implement for the next creating track or task, after selecting this implement, this information will be copied from the glossary. Now this stage also that it's not synchronized between different devices, but on one device it will be available. So if it's necessary to organize this data, you can update information in glossary of your implement parameters for the using for faster and starting your next tracks and new type of operation. About surveying, so I switching between different topics, and it's really interesting that today we made a like overview whole products, whole functionality just and some question we receive about the surveying, and we have a notes in application, and interesting later maybe in the chat to receive that information. Is it available for you using this that's notes in record keeping allow to keep information, define information about their trees, power lines, and on a field. You can define the radius of this obstacle, and you also can measure the geometry of this obstacle. Now the possibility to export this data is not available, and if it's necessary, you can vote for this functionality. Just write again, for example, like about the implement parameters, just asking. We are collecting this request, and if it's necessary functionality, we can implement. Some cases we have that feature request. So if some functionality is necessary for your business, and you see that it's important and it's still in waiting stage, by voting you can just order this functionality. We can implement by sharing costs, and so that can make a faster prioritization of development for this functionality. So let's keep in mind this option also. So that's with notes, you can put it information about obstacle, and in a task, I think that maybe this misses this functionality. We have a importing GeoJSON. So that importing GeoJSON format, which can keep information about geometry, and it's like shape, SRI format, but it's can readable, convertible, understandable format. It's now that's popular format of transferring geometry data, and you can attach geometry in format GeoJSON to the task for the spraying, for example, about the drainage system, for example, or some pumps. So that's about obstacle also, And this information will be displayed during navigation as additional layer. So that's and you can use that some online service GeoJSON for creating additional information which specified for this operation. So you can mark region where you can take attention for this area. You can make a maybe available rate conversion map and see this visualization on your map. So you can use this option for uploading additional geometry for visualizing data during your navigation. And if this functionality is applicable, available, you can share it also, your idea how you need additional things. So that's want to say that about this functionality, attachment in a spray, in a task. So you need to, in a task, press plus and upload this GeoJSON file. Okay. So that's a short overview of what we have now and what we want to do. So in navigation app, tractor navigation app, design it with not only field guidance functionality. Record keeping now allow organize your data according to the type of operation. And we see that we will use this type of operation for extending this functionality. For example, during integration with implement, for the specific operation, you will get an additional route planner or some application map generator and some with specific implements. And according to this operation type, we will extend this functionality. And the question with priority, that currently we see that some available functionality and product with integration with implements. We receive a request, and important that what you need, you all time write us. We looking because our product based on your feedbacks. And now we see that land leveling for some countries where there's rice planting and we need to land leveling operation more often than 3 years. we see that we can use, we can create this integration, this land leveler, this valve, with our field B, and it can be integration. And interesting that that's how it's available for you, and we can discuss in other webinar regarding integration with implements. Also, we see that is necessary, the most important operation is planting, and now we looking at companies who is producer of planters and provide this integration with planter. We want to integrate our field B with some planters for make a differential and high precision seeding operation. Also for spreading operation and second with integration also with external implements and for harvesting, for example, operation, just we receive a request about the understanding what value of moisture of products which you harvesting, this additional sensor which install it on a harvester or connect to the your harvester. This also in our R&D stage investigation, we see that what we can do in shortest period to deliver product, and if you see that it's necessary to integrate with your equipment, for example, for spraying operation, we receive some question about that some Raven systems has a boom control, section control with implement, and if it's available for you, all time asking support, and we can discuss that options how we can upgrade integrate with your equipment in separately. Just I want to explain that what we can do with our navigation according that when you see that when you create task seeding, fertilizing, tilling, and other, some transportation operation maybe. If you want to track movement between inventory to fields back, and you want to track time, for example, just share it with your needs, what you can, of how we can improve also operation. So that's also we see that in next year, so that we will make a more close CAN-bus, ISA-bus integration for the new equipment. Yeah, and of course that depends of size of company, of farms. We see that some countries has a popular farm management system. So that's if you see that your neighborhoods, your friends using the farm management good government report system, and you see that in a farmer, you see that areas amount of material, just share this information that we know that's good farm management system. We keep this information record keeping. We do in record keeping in eFarm, in FieldB, in the tractor navigation app, and we can synchronize data. How we can do it, and you can share this info. We will see that is it possible to prioritize it. If some services is available for you, we show this in DVI maps, some satellites information for you. You can also tell us. We think that we can add additional layers for visualizing this data, and so it's also possible by our system. We can do it. Depends on country, region, of course, your field, environment, but we can localize this solution for some countries. So if you see that some ideas, you can share it with us, and we'll see. Also, we receive about interesting that case about the driving to home from the field autonomously. Unfortunately, currently we have a lot of safety restrictions when automatic steering is not allowed to use on a road. So that's safety restriction not allowed at that moment to drive, but we think in the future, maybe in near future, it will be available. So that's when regulation will be more flexible, and maybe we'll back, but in the future. So drone on the fields and autonomous navigation, we also think that in few years, some equipment, some operation will be do autonomously. And just for example, in last year, we made a prototype together with Dutch company, which called House Harvesting. This project called Agrobotics. So we made upgrade of normal harvester for fully autonomous. So this this harvester equipped with FieldB L1 first generation. It's interesting that with RTK and autonomous controller also designed and made it by us. We choose that open source technological stack, but we made this autonomous mission, safety requirements, and we proceed with this prototype one field last year. So that's we see that good opportunity to upgrade current vehicle to autonomous work. So if you're thinking about the autonomous work, driving, for example, on John Deere controller tractors, which has stereo radio functionality, also share these ideas, and we can discuss. And the last I want to tell, and that's it's not one webinar, that's overview of whole topics which we can discuss, and we want to specify that next webinars which we can concentrate on one topics which you're interested in, because all audience currently is waiting automatic steering equation, other for survey, and other thinking only about autonomous navigation. So if you have some interested topic, just write down in the chat currently what you are interested for the next webinar. So now you have a chance to prioritize the next meeting webinar, and most popular topic we will start from this question. That's mean the next webinar can be with open discussion. We can discuss personally that's your ideas, your question, your problems, for example, your suggestion specifically for each topic. Yeah, I see that you're voting. Thank you for voting. First of all, I'm IT farmer. I want to say that our company IT, and we see that's how important to support you. And so we want to make you be happier, but sometimes it takes time to be happy. Thank you for your attention. And so Natalie, maybe you.
Thank you, Alexey. Yes. We also promised to answer a few questions, and I think there were some questions. Maybe Taras, you can pick them up from the chat. Thank you very much, guys, for your patience and participation. And I think, this meeting was actually for really people who are interested in technologies and has already some understanding of how these technologies are working. So that's why it's interesting for you to hear these things and learn more about them. And Taras, do you have some questions that we can pick up from the chat?
I try to reply for each of them as soon as they got to the chat. So, for example, a question from the Voltaire about the settings of the steering system. They were covered into the new connection manager, and the auto steer connection is still in the settings, but it is united with the field BL1, field BL2, and auto steer into one, the GPS source. So right now, it is not divided to the different groups because different connection types, and it was gathered together in the GPS source. So you just choose your navigation system component, and then field B assist for the next steps for the connection. The question was about the any time frame from the Daniel Blank time frame for sprayer control and isobus controller. Right now, actually, it hasn't been estimated yet. As soon as we will start developing process of it, about the section control or other control of the implement, it will be announced and for sure shared the survey or some kind of the questionnaire to be sure that it will be user experienced well and comfortable for you. If I miss something, please let me know.
Okay, thank you, Taras. Okay, guys.